Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to give a demo of single phase cycloconverter. So the single phase cycloconverter or a cycloconverter is a device in which we can convert a fixed frequency AC current, alternating current, by means of using a cycloconverter or a semiconductor device in which we are forming a bridge circuit of thyristors. And for this, using this, we can convert the fixed AC of a fixed frequency to a variable frequency AC or the alternating current. So the basically cycloconverter converts the frequency in different waveforms, or we can observe the output as per the frequency changes. So this is our complete setup of single phase cycloconverter, in which this is the single phase cycloconverter schematic diagram and the basic panel, in which we are using four thyristors SCR. The T1, T2, T3, T4 are four different thyristors by which we can make the parallel circuit of two thyristors each. And this is the AC input of this circuit or the complete setup, and by which we can get the AC output. This is the on off switch for the MCB inside this, and this is complete circuit is protected from overload and short circuit protections. This is the power on off switch to provide the gate pulses continuously to the circuit. And they are the voltmeters, which reads up to 0 to 300 volts. And this is the ampere meter of up to 10 ampere ratings in the alternating current. So this is the single phase cycloconverter firing unit over here. And this unit generates 8 line synchronized isolated trigger pulses to trigger SCRs connected in the center tap transformer and bridge the tap cycloconverter power circuit. This unit can also be used as a single phase converter firing unit to conduct different single phase converter experiments. This firing circuit is based on RAM comparator and a counter scheme using microcontroller, and pulse transformer isolation is provided for trigger outputs. The signal at various points of the firing circuit is provided as a test point. These are the test signals. You can use this test point, and this circuit is worked directly on the 230 volt AC mains, and gate drive current is of 200 milliampere to trigger the wide range of devices. Firing variation from 180 to 0 degree on a graduated scale is provided, and this can be used for 0 to 180, or both the phase differences can be seen using this knob. And this is the frequency deviation switch. These are the two cycle button here. This is the up button to increase the deviations, and this is the down button to decrease the deviation. We can provide the frequency division from 1, 2, 3 up to 10 division. You can take the frequency as our frequency in the domestic power supply is 50 hertz. So we can provide it from 50 by 2, which is the 25 hertz, to up to 50 by 10, which is the 5 hertz. So we can get different type of frequency varying through this firing unit. These are the different gate pulses or the test points of all the different deviations. We can test all the different firing pulses using these test points. So this is the isolation transformer with 5 ampere ratings, and in which we have provided 0, 30, 30 and 0, 60, 60, two types of different power supplies. These power supplies can be used to provide input on the cycloconverter, and then we connect the output supply and make the cycloconverter circuit, and then we connect firing circuit. Or we have also provided a R load. This is the 150 ohm 5 ampere rheostat as an R load for this circuit, and this is the L load over here of 0, 50, 100 and 250 microhenry inductance in it. So this is the complete setup of 5 ampere of inductance load, L load, R load. So we can completely use this cycloconverter, and we will perform the experiment of changing the frequency through different deviations also. And then we apply the output on the R load, L load and RL load in combined. So we are also offering a user manual in which all the details about the single phase cycloconverter and the circuit diagram and how to perform the experiment on this kit is described in this user manual. And these are the patch codes which are required to do the experiment are also included in the accessories. So this is the single phase cyclo converter complete setup. The order code for this setup is 20213868.1.23. You can use this order code to check out the different specification of this device and to use this order code by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. So now we are going to follow the procedure as described in the user manual, and then we complete the circuit diagram of the single phase cyclo converter. Also given in the user manual, we have to complete the circuit diagram as described in the procedure of the manual. So we will start building up the circuit on the kit, and then we first tag the waveforms on the firing of the different deviations also and the different gate pulses also. Then we connect the power supply to the circuit, and then we see output and also see the variations of the frequency through this cyclo converter. Now we will first check the different deviations and gate pulses of the single phase firing controller. So we will on this circuit by using this power on button and connect the ground. And now we will test the different variations of the gate pulses on the DSO using this. So this is at the 1, this is at 2, this is at 3rd, the 4th one, 5th one is slightly out of the deviations, gate pulses. So 5th one, 6th one and 7th one. So these are the different deviations of the gate pulses. Now we can also check the different deviations using this. So this is the first. For test point, for observing the gate pulses, we have to connect the CRO between any of the gate and cathode of the pulses. So we will use the 4mm patch cord. So we can connect the CRO probe to any of the gate and cathode terminal, and then we observe the gate pulses on different frequency variations. As we change the frequency variations, the gate pulses also changes accordingly. So the complete setup of the gate pulses at different values will be observed to the different angles. So this is 10 different deviations of the frequency through this firing unit, and the different gate pulses will be provided on different firing angle, and then we achieve the different frequency of the input at the output side to change the frequency. So now we are going to build up the circuit of the cyclo converter using this main unit. So for first we have to provide the AC supply. So we will provide 30 volt on the 230 volt section, 0 with the 0, and another 30 volt of the center tapping to the 230 volt input. So this is the AC input sockets at which we have provided the 230 volt AC supply. On the this toggle switch is the controlling for the MCB on and off. So as we on the circuit, the 230 volt provided supply will be at or the AC output terminals. So right now we will turn off this supply. So we are going to make the circuit. Now as described in the circuit, we have to connect the anode of T1 and cathode of T3 of both the transistor. So we short circuit this. So this is the anode of T1. This will be connected with the cathode of T3 Similarly, both the other end will be also short circuited like this. Similarly, for the second parallel circuit, we will connect cathode of T4 and anode of T2 describing in the circuit. So this is the anode of T2. This will be connected with the cathode of T4, and the cathode of T2 will be connected with the anode of T4. So this is the circuit here. Now, to provide the AC supply from the output sockets, we will connect the one tapping of the 30 volt supply to the short circuit of T1 and T3. Anode of T1, we can use the anode of T1 here. So this is the anode of T1. We will use the red patch code for this, as we are working with the supply here. So we'll connect one tapping to the anode of T1, and another tap of the 30 volt supply will be connected with the anode of T2 according to the circuit. So this is the anode of T2, so we will connect supply here. Now, for adding the voltmeter in the circuit, we will connect the anode of T3 to the one terminal of voltmeter. So anode of T3, this is the anode of T3, so we will connect anode of T3 to the one terminal of voltmeter, and another terminal of voltmeter will be going to the center of the center tap transformer. So this will be connected with the center tap. Now we will short circuit the anode of T3 and T4 to complete the bridge. So we will connect the anode of T3. This is the anode of T3. This will be connected with the anode of T4. So this is anode of T4 here. Sorry. So this circuit has been completed right now. Now we will connect the cathode of T2 to using the ampere meter. So ampere meter will be connected in series. So we will connect cathode of T2. So this is the cathode of T2. And now we will connect this to the one end of ampere meter. And another end of ampere meter will be connected with the rheostat or the R load for this circuit. So we will connect the R load for the rheostat to the another end of this ampere meter, and the rheostat's other end will be going to the center tap. So other end of this rheostat will be connected with the center tap here. Now our circuit has been done. We have to verify our circuit every time we will connect. Now we will provide the gate pulses through the firing unit. So we will just connect the T1, T2, T3 and T4, all the gate and cathode. An extra terminal for the cathode is also provided on the circuit, so we can easily connect all the gate pulses through patch codes. Or we have to connect the circuit for providing the gate pulses. So red one for the gate and black one for the cathode. Similarly, this is the T2, so make sure you will connect the T2 with the T2 circuit. So this is the T2 thyristor here. Now T3, so this is the T3, and for the last one is the T4. So this is T4 gate and this is T4 cathode. So this is the complete circuitry. using the manual. Now we will turn on the circuit and connect the CRO on the load or the rheostat, which is the R load in this case, and then we observe the frequency, and then we turn the frequency deviation to different variations, and then we observe the output frequency. The input frequency is of the 50 Hz right now, because the supply is the 220 volt is the input for this isolation transformer, and the tapping is the 30 volt AC. So the frequency is approximately same of the input. So this is the 30 volt output from this isolation tapping transformer, and this output is provided to the input of the cycloconverter. So we have the 50 Hz frequency. Generally cycloconverters are used only to the down, because the limited frequency is the main frequency which is from the source. The source frequency is the 50 Hz right now for this case. So we will just divide the frequencies to the different deviations of the firing units using this firing unit. So we will see the frequency using this different variations, and then we convert the frequency of source, which is the 50 Hz, to the different frequencies and observe the output waveforms. Now always make sure the circuit should be verified according to the circuit diagram before power on the circuit. Now we will connect the CRO probe across the load terminals. So this is the rheostat terminal directly. So we will connect the positive of the CRO probe to this, and this is the ground terminal of the load. So we will connecting the CRO on the load, across the load. Now we will observe the waveforms. Now we will first turn on the frequency, sorry, the firing unit, and at which we will first using this up down switch for the first deviation, you will get the same output of the cycloconverter, which is the input frequency of the 50 Hz, and the 50 Hz will be same output on the circuit. So we'll turn on the MCB and power on the firing circuit. Here you can see output is 30 volt amperes are also shown in the ampere meter, and the output waveform is of the 50 Hz on the CRO you can observe. So this is the 50 Hz of the same deviations, because we do not provide any of the deviations changes. Now we will turn off the circuit again. Always turn off the circuit before changing the deviations. Now we will divide the frequency from the second deviation. So the 50 Hz is divided by 2. So we now will achieve the frequency of 50 by 2, which is approximately 25 Hz. So we'll again turn on the circuit, and this is now voltage is about the half, and also the frequency of this circuit is 25 Hz. You can observe on the CRO. So this is how cycloconverter decreasing the frequency in the fractions. Now as we again change the deviations, we will again achieve the frequency at different deviations. So this is the third frequency. So approximately we will divide 50 by 3. So we will get approximately 17 or 16 Hz in the output. So this is the 16-17 Hz output of the frequency we are getting on the output. Now again we will turn off the circuit and change the deviations to the 4. So we will approximately get the 12 and 13 of the Hz, which is the fractions of this frequency output. Now you can see the frequency output is approximately 12 and a half. So this is approximately the divided by 50 Hz divided by 3, or 50 Hz divided by the 4. So this is how the cycloconverter is changing the frequency. Now again we will change the deviations to 6 for this time. Our frequency is now again down to 8.3 Hz approximately, and the pulses or the deviations are also now changing to the 3 of the positive and 3 of the negative. Again turn off the circuit for negative cycle. We will now turn the frequency to 8 deviations. So 50 divided by 8, it should be the approximate output. Now also you can see the deviations of this output waveform are now also changing for 3 to 4 and the output frequency is 6.2 hertz for this case. Now we will going to the maximum deviations, which is the 10. So the frequency which is 50 hertz should be maximally divided and changes to the 50 divided by 10. So our output should be about the 5 hertz of the frequency. Now we will on the circuit and see the output. So our output is approximately 5 hertz. We will tune the CRO just a little bit and we will get approximately 5 hertz of the output frequency. So this is how cycloconverter converts the frequency. This experiment is of the at the R load. We can use the L load for experiment also. So we will just have to connect the R and L load in the series and then we see the output waveform also for this type of load. Now we are going to just connect the R and L load to see how the waveforms changes due to these loads. Now for connecting the L load, we will remove the R load from the ampere meter. Now we will use a patch code and connect the L load from the zero and the rheostat will be directly connected to the any of the tapping of L loads. So our L load is now 50 microhenry and R load is 150 ohm of the rheostat resistance. Now we will observe the output waveform due to both this load. What is the variation on the CRO? So now we are again going to turn on the circuit. First turn the firing circuit and change the deviations to the 2 for the this case. And now we will turn on the supply and power on the circuit. Here you can see on the CRO a slight turn due to the L load is showing on the waveform. Slight glitch of the L load of the negative pulse is due to the inductance is showing in the waveform also. So this is how the L load affects the output waveform. Same procedure for different deviations is also observed. You can see 25 hertz is the second deviation is observing in the output L load. Now we will again we can increase the inductance in different values. So we will turn off the circuit of the load and increase the inductance up to 100 henry and turn on the circuit again. Here you can see the load waveform is also varies due to the effect of the inductance. Here you can see the effect of inductance in the negative cycle is clearly seen on the waveforms. Similarly, all the different inductance values are used to provide the different resistance and different values. So we can change the resistance also through this rheostat and this will affect the load waveform also. So this is all about this practical of the single phase cycloconverter. We have tried to explain as much as to do the experiment for the manual and for the ease of the working with this kit. And we have also using this different kits on the R load and L load. You can also perform the experiment directly on the L load to get the different waveforms output accordingly. And in the user manual, all the details waveforms are also given and how the cycloconverter circuitry and the cycloconverter theory is also given in the user manual. You can study the different theories. So this is it for this video. For any queries, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for any kind of details and any kind of supports. Thank you.